Indiana. I did not know about the village at all. I had no idea. Mr. P.T. Barnum, who is a great entrepreneur, had set up this tour. It was the most famous tour of its time. People thronged to hear me. Many, many thousands. And Mr. Barnum made many, many dollars from all of this wonderful attendance. Yes. And so the people of Madison and Mr. Wilson said, Jenny Lind will be in Louisville and will be going to Cincinnati. Therefore, we will talk to Mr. Barnum and to his man, and we will arrange for a concert. And Mr. Wilson, he set it up, and he promised that he would pay $5,000 for one concert by Jenny Lind on April 11th. Well, we arrived. Now, I must explain to you that Jenny Lind was not, as we are today, a simple duet between me and Otto. No, Jenny Lind was with an entire company. First of all, when we came to perform, I had a wonderful baritone, Mr. Biletti. And then I also had picked up another wonderful singer, a tenor, Mr. Salvi, that we picked up when we came to Louisville. And in addition, I had a full conductor, and I had all of the orchestra that we need, although sometimes we brought musicians locally. But then we also had with us my wonderful dresser, Madame Andersson. She's a lovely Swedish lady that had come for me for many, many years. And my personal advisor, my financial advisor. And then, on this time, a Mr. Goldberg, who wrote everything out that we did on this tour. And you can read it, it's there. A beautiful book. And so everything that we did was documented. And when we arrived in town, it was 6 o'clock. And here we came. Well, Mr. Barnum's advance man had come the day before. And Mr. Wilson had said to him, I'm sorry, I did not raise the $5,000. I only raised $3,600. Well, Mr. Barnum's man did not believe him. He said, this man is lying. He saw they had this auction, and the tickets were selling like mad. People were coming from everywhere. No, he said. Not when we arrived, he told Mr. Barnum, he said, Mr. Barnum, this man is not true, he's not honest, and we will not perform it. Mr. Barnum said, no, we will not. But I said, the people of Madison are in no way responsible for this chicanery. They have nothing to do with this. And I have come ready to sing, and I wish to sing, and therefore, I will sing. And so, we performed that night, right here. But the place we performed, well, we joked about it after. Oh my, it was really not a concert hall at all, not enough. It was a large warehouse, right? And it was owned by Mr. Phillips, who did pork packing. That means, you know, it usually did not have singers like Madame Lind, myself. It had lard in it and other things. So it was a big rock, but you can tell me that they had just whitewashed the whole place. And they had put baths of green all around, perhaps to disguise some of this pork. I do not know. But it was so marvelous because all the people loved the songs. They loved what we did and they wanted everything that happened. So we were very pleased. I was very pleased and we had a good nap on the pork palace of Madison. Oh my dears, life has been very good to me. But there's a special reason why I took on this tour. In 1848, I had been traveling all over Europe and had sung in many, many places, including to Queen Victoria and all of those wonderful moments. And then I met a wonderful man. I had known so many But Frederick Chopin was very special. He was Polish, and I was Swedish. And so in 1848, he came to London, and he came to one of my performances, thanks to a friend, and afterward we had dinner. And we had this wonderful evening. He played, and I sang. I sang for him some of my Swedish songs, and he loved them. He said, "You are very Slavonic. We are Polish, and you are Swedish, but we are as close as Italian and Spaniard." We were very close in that way. And of course, we spoke in French because I did not speak Polish, and he did not speak Swedish. So we spoke in French. And it was a wonderful time. He then went to Paris, and we spent time there together as well. But by 1849, Paris was in a terrible situation. It was upheaval, political.